So our last handler is NewPost handler. This is actually should look fairly familiar to you. This kind of has the general kind of form submission error handling process we've been using before. So if you just do a get on that page, NewPost/NewPost, we return the NewPost HTML. And if you post to it, we try to verify the form. So the first thing we do is we get the two parameters out of the request, subject and content. Those are the name of the form fields. If we don't have a subject and content, we'll do this clause first. We create an error message, subject and content please, and we render the form again with the user's entered subject, content, and error. A new post HTML expects these parameters. If they did enter a good subject and content, we create a new post. I set my parent. Again, you don't have to set a parent. You know, might make future organization easier. I was learning data store myself. I set the subject to equal the subject that the user entered, and I set the content to be the content that the user entered. Remember, the two date parameters, created and last modified, will be set automatically. We call p.put to store this element in the database. And then I redirect the user to /blog/the ID of the element. And this is how you get an object's ID in DataStore. And let's see this in action in the browser one more time, now that we know what all the pieces are. So here we are on the new post again. Let's submit this form without a subject and body. You can see that we have the error message, subject and content please. So we'll enter our subject and a little body. And when we click submit, we get redirected to /blog/4, which is the ID of this post. And you can see our subject and our body. And if we go back to our blog's front page, we can see all of our entries. That's the homework.